Hi everyone, my name is Stephanie, and this is what's new in the Microsoft Edge Developer Tools in version 102. In version 102, there's a new browser preview and source map support in VS Code. You can save all strings from a Heap snapshot to a JSON file. The memory tool has new filters for retainers. The inspect tool's accessibility has been improved. You can learn about experiments in DevTools from settings. We've improved the accessibility of the DevTools in high contrast mode. And finally, network settings now display better in narrow layouts. First up, the Edge Developer Tools for Visual Studio Code now has a new browser preview that allows you to enable different devices. You can also preview the current project in different modes like dark, light, print, and high contrast. To make accessibility testing easier, you can also show a blurred version or simulate different color deficiencies. Other new features include a simpler way to toggle CSS mirroring, which now also supports source maps. This means that you can debug CSS created by Sass, React, and other abstractions live in the browser and see the changes in the source files. Next, when taking a Heap snapshot in the memory tool in version 102, you can now export all string objects from the snapshot to a JSON file. From the memory tool, select the new Save All to File button next to the string entry in the constructor section. The memory tool will export a JSON file containing all of the string objects from the Heap snapshot. In previous versions of Microsoft Edge, cycles and internal nodes were displayed in the retainer section of a Heap snapshot. Cycles refer to nodes that appear at least twice in a retainer path, with one of those appearances being later in the path than the other. In terms of freeing up memory, removing the first appearance is the most important, but the second and potentially subsequent appearances are still displayed in the retainer section. Internal nodes are objects specific to V8, the JavaScript engine in Microsoft Edge, that are also displayed in the retainer section. In version 102, the retainer section in the memory tool now has new filters to hide cycles and hide internal nodes in the retainer path. Using these filters will help simplify the retainer path. Next, some users felt frustrated when the hover overlay for the node they selected was constantly changing when using Select Element in the Elements panel. This was especially painful for customers using a screen magnifier. To address this, we introduced Ctrl-Alt as a key modifier to keep the node and overlay selected when using the Inspect tool. You can also use Ctrl to hide the overlay if needed. Next up, in the DevTools Settings Experiments page, checkboxes now have a help icon. Click a help icon to get more information about an experimental feature. The help icon opens the relevant section in Experimental Features. In previous versions of Microsoft Edge, drop-down menus in the Issues tool, buttons in the Detached Elements tool, and the Activity bar in Focus mode didn't render correctly in High Contrast mode. In Microsoft Edge version 102, these issues have been fixed. And finally, in previous versions of Edge, opening network settings with the gear icon in the Network tool would overlap when the DevTools were resized to be very narrow. In version 102, this issue has been fixed, and the individual settings now display better in narrow layouts. And that's it for what's new with the Microsoft Edge Developer Tools in version 102. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at MSEdgeDev, and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in version 103.